Hi there, my name is Dick Gould. I'm going to be guiding you through this informative presentation that discusses the relationship between quality and social responsibility. This presentation will take approximately 25 minutes, so sit back and relax as I share with you how you, as a quality professional, can use your expertise to help your organization achieve sustainable, socially responsible results. We start with a very simple yet imperative question. Why should we, quality professionals, care about social responsibility? I'll refer to social responsibility as SR. As we will see throughout this presentation, SR is a real and permanent force in business. It's receiving increased attention from customers, investors, executives, employees, and governments. Fortunately, SR is simply a corollary of quality's traditional scope of work. By paying attention to SR, we can help our organizations better align their too often isolated SR investments to core business strategies. Finally, and more directly related to our profession, engaging with SR enables us to define and evolve quality using the language of 21st century business. A formal definition of SR is the responsibility of an organization for the impacts of its decisions and activities on society and the environment through transparent and ethical behavior. SR is known by many names. For example, some concentrate on the going green aspect of SR, which refers to environmental social responsibility. CSR refers to corporate social responsibility. Then there is global citizenship. For purpose of this presentation, we will look at SR as the umbrella term for all of these definitions. Society is placing increasing demands on organizations to operate in a socially responsible manner. Research demonstrates that most consumers, 60 to 79% in fact, expect organizations to be responsible regarding issues of health and safety, environmental sustainability, ensuring responsible supply chains, and treating workers fairly. But there exists a widespread lack of clarity about what social responsibility means and how to accomplish it. ASQ understands SR to mean that people and organizations behave ethically and with sensitivity towards social, cultural, economic, and environmental issues. Striving for social responsibility helps individuals, organizations, and governments have a positive impact on development, business, and society. So, why should individuals and organizations be socially responsible? Consumers are demanding it. They want to know that the workers are working in a safe environment. They want to know that foods are processed safely. They want to make sure that children are not being exploited as a source of cheap labor. They are concerned about environmental impact. Socially responsible attributes positively influence consumer purchasing decisions. It makes good business sense. Many companies have proclaimed their commitment to socially responsible business practices in annual reports, on their websites, and through policy statements. As a result of these activities, many have reported tangible business gains. It produces bottom-line results. 66% of chief financial officers agreed that environmental, social, and governance programs create value for shareholders, and 66% of executives believe shareholder value created by environmental and governance programs will increase in the next 5 years relative to their contributions before the economic crisis. Build stronger brand. Consumers look up to organizations that are socially responsible and enact sustainable practices. This adds to the credibility of the company and the work that they do to make a difference. SR adds value to brands and provides organizations with a competitive advantage. So, what are the core issues affecting SR? SR has evolved in many companies and organizations from a public relations effort into a process improvement strategy. SR is growing for a number of reasons. Stakeholders seek transparency. Stakeholders want demonstration of social responsibility measurements and transparent reports on environmental, social, and economic factors. The growing influence of the Global Reporting Initiative a standardization of sustainability reporting systems, illustrates the growing market demand for clear and specific public reporting. World of instant information. Taxpayers, customers, suppliers, the media, etc. can all quickly and easily learn about an organization's reputation and practices, as well as its bad decisions, scandals, and policies. This trend is particularly important regarding supply chain management. Frequently, news stories chide organizations for using suppliers with poor operating practices. Think about Apple's issues with suppliers of its iPhone starting in 2011. Government getting involved. Governments have traditionally regulated many components of SR. For example, environmental issues, labor laws, contract laws, fair operating practices, consumer rights, etc. But in recent years, governments all over the globe have expanded their interest in SR. Global, federal, state, and local policies, fiscal incentives, and voluntary guidelines mean many public and private institutions and companies will need to measure, report, and reduce environmental waste and emissions. Financial savings. Thanks to improved technology and processes, business and organizations can see tremendous savings opportunities in pursuing SR-related tactics. For example, Goodwill Industries in Illinois saved approximately $120,000 on cooking oil by removing deep fat fryers. In addition to providing healthier food, it cut the number of food service-related slips and falls and reduced preventative maintenance costs. So SR is a force that demands our attention. We have defined social responsibility and have identified some of the core issues. Let's now address the connection between quality and social responsibility. SR activity has grown exponentially over the past several years. There was a doubling in SR reports issued by S&P 500 businesses from 2011 to 2012. Now, more than half of S&P 500 companies issue SR reports. SR represents a major business investment and a significant part of many organizations. But traditionally, quality professionals haven't interacted with these efforts. True TQM demands engagement with all parts of an organization. Ensuring customer satisfaction is a key focal point for quality. A growing percentage of today's consumers expect that organizations are socially responsible and demonstrate that responsibility through a clear public strategy and detailed reporting. However, one of the major issues with SR is a lack of continuous improvement methods and tools. Traditionally, SR efforts have been fragmented and limited to corporate philanthropy. An opportunity exists to use quality to fully integrate SR into core business practices, benchmark and track SR improvements, and maximize SR investments. To further demonstrate the connection between quality and social responsibility, every 3 years, the American Society for Quality conducts a futures study to brainstorm and envision what society might look like in 10 to 15 years. In 2011, over 140 participants from 33 countries evaluated several dozen social, political, economic, and technical forces that could shape the future of quality. What was the number one force that quality professionals see as having an impact in the profession in the years to come? Yes, it was global responsibility, which is really social responsibility, but with specific thought to the global impact of our local actions. Let's take a closer look at the connection between quality and social responsibility. There are a number of quality tools and methods that can serve as effective ways for organizations to address the social responsibility challenge. This fishbone or Ishikawa diagram illustrates the various components that make up social responsibility from a quality perspective. In 1988, the Malcolm Baldrige Performance Excellence Criteria were first released. The criteria contributed to the understanding of social responsibility in its core value statements. Organizations were challenged to respond to questions such as, describe procedures for compliance with safety, health, and environmental standards. Describe mechanisms of corporate support of quality assurance activities outside the company. The Baldrige criteria emphasize social responsibility as one of the 11 core values underpinning the Baldrige Award. In 2003, the Baldrige criteria were refined to include a focus on governance accountability, which is a principal component of social responsibility. The criteria states, and this is just a portion of it, an organization's leaders should stress responsibilities to the public, ethical behavior, and the need to practice good citizenship. Leaders should be role models for your organization in focusing on business ethics and protection of public health, safety, and the environment. So, how do we go about measuring SR success? What gauge can we use? Right now, there are a number of different standards by which social responsibility is gauged. Each of these has different criteria, so it is quite possible for an organization to rank very high on one list and very low on another. For example, one standard may place importance on environmental responsibility, while another may value labor issues and responsibility. To help alleviate this problem, the International Organization for Standardization has developed ISO 26000, a consensus standard on social responsibility that is applicable to all organizations. ASQ was awarded the administration of the U.S. Technical Advisory Group, TAG, on social responsibility by the American National Standards Institute. The U.S. TAG is the U.S. member of the International Working Group chartered with developing the International Standard on Social Responsibility. The ISO 26000 Social Responsibility Standard provides the following benefits. It assists organizations in addressing their social responsibilities while respecting cultural, societal, environmental, and legal differences, and economic development conditions. It provides practical guidance related to operationalizing social responsibility, identifying and engaging with stakeholders, and enhancing credibility of reports and claims made about social responsibility. It also emphasizes performance results and improvement, thereby increasing confidence and satisfaction in organizations among their customers and other stakeholders. It provides consistency with and is not in conflict with existing documents, international treaties, and conventions and existing ISO standards. It is important to note that ISO 26000 is a guidance standard and not one that an organization becomes certified to, like ISO 9000 or 14000. It is a voluntary standard. Companies choose which aspects they are able to comply with, and it is quite possible that a company will not be compliant with all areas of the standard. The standard was released in November 2010. It can be purchased on the ASQ website. When understanding the impact quality and SR has on a business or organization, it's important to refer to the triple bottom line: social, economic, and environmental. In difficult economic times, organizations are forced to do more with less while at the same time comply with numerous regulations. For instance, as to the economy, U.S. socially responsible-based investments account for $2.7 trillion. As to the environment, U.S. retail companies spend $20 billion on energy each year. The carbon dioxide produced as a result is harmful to the environment. And as to social impact, U.S. service-providing industries are expected to increase employment by 13%, 15.8 million jobs, from 2006 to 2016, affecting thousands of communities. In order to be better positioned for the future, businesses, organizations, and government entities need to understand the importance of addressing SR through quality management and improvement tools that can help reduce costs, improve efficiency, and have a positive impact on their communities. Quality professionals have the skill sets and tools to improve social responsibility results. Let's take a look at a few quality tools that can help leaders ensure both customer satisfaction and business results. The Malcolm Baldrige criteria contributes to the understanding of how social responsibility can be used to improve performance. It asks organizations and companies for information about how they consider the well-being of environmental, social, and economic systems to which they contribute. First released in 1988, the criteria was expanded in 2007 to include nonprofit organizations such as governmental agencies, charities, and professional organizations. One important item to note, ASQ administers the Malcolm Baldrige National Quality Award under contract to the National Institute of Standards and Technology. Lean manufacturing is a system of techniques and activities for running a manufacturing or service operation. The techniques and activities differ according to the application at hand, but they have the same underlying principle, the elimination of all non-value-adding activities and waste from the business. By eliminating the waste of overproduction, transportation, inventory, scrap, motion, etc. through lean manufacturing processes and quality tools, companies are practicing social responsibility. Lean enterprise extends this concept through the entire value stream or supply chain. The leanest factory cannot achieve its full potential if it has to work with non-lean suppliers and subcontractors. Six Sigma is used to develop statistical methods to identify and remove the causes of defects and errors in social, environmental, and financial issues, and create a special infrastructure of people to address the concept within an organization. It is a fact-based, data-driven philosophy of quality improvement that values defect prevention over defect detection. Six Sigma quality performance means no more than 3.4 defects per million opportunities. There are also performance standards for 3, 4, and 5 Sigma. It drives customer satisfaction and bottom-line results by reducing variation and waste, thereby promoting a competitive advantage. Six Sigma applies anywhere that variation and waste exist, so employees at all levels of a business can play important roles in Six Sigma projects. The bottom line is organizations and businesses that merge quality and social responsibility into their practices will not only reduce waste and help the environment, but will also see results. By focusing on an appropriate set of sources of competitive advantage, companies can use environmentally beneficial strategies selectively to become more competitive over the long run. Implementation of these strategies will require fundamental changes in core business processes such as product development, marketing and sales, manufacturing, supply chain management, and customer service. Companies that choose to be socially responsible can use quality tools to achieve these goals. Quality tools and social responsibility work together to give companies competitive advantage. Seeing the powerful results that SR efforts can have, what initiatives is ASQ working on to promote social responsibility? The SRO.org was created to help the world understand how social responsibility and quality can achieve sustainable results. Version 2.0 of the site will be released in May 2013. While on the site, get involved and share your stories. Together, we can better define the relationship between quality and SR, build a global body of knowledge, and achieve greater results. Here are a few other SR-related causes that ASQ is working on. Pathways to Social Responsibility. Pathways is a publication that highlights the creativity of organizations that have successfully integrated SR into their missions. Since 2009, this initiative has profiled effective practices in a cross-sector of organizations, ranging from global corporations to local governments and nonprofits. 2013 will see the fifth edition of Pathways. The Spencer Hutchins Social Responsibility Medal was given out for the first time at the 2010 ASQ World Conference. The medal recognizes individuals who demonstrate outstanding leadership as an advocate for social responsibility. We look forward to awarding this medal in the years ahead to those that truly demonstrate their commitment to SR activities. The last program I want to make you aware of is Quality for Life. This program seeks to share the stories of professionals that use quality tools to positively impact the lives of others. The screenshot is the main page of the Quality for Life website. As you can see, it is a very dynamic site, which includes an interactive map, video box, and social media networks. Make sure to spend some time on the site and view some of the great stories that ASQ members have submitted. Here are a few websites that you can visit for more information. Thank you very much for your kind attention during this presentation. If you have any questions, feel free to call ASQ at 1-800-248-1946 and ask for Dave Salata, the Social Responsibility Program Manager at ASQ Headquarters. And remember, ASQ is the global voice of quality.